We're at Steak of America Stadium in Chuckett, South Carolina. The only place where you can eat barbecue while watching players get barbecued. I can't stop thinking about barbecue. Is it obvious? Barbecue. Mm-mm, good. And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Atlanta Vultures take on the Carolina Panzers. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello again, everybody. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
That's me.
And his mutant hobbit head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
How about you shut the fuck up?
Well played, Jr. Moving on. And it's first and ten. First down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten.
Wow, he took like 1,000 volts of shock there. They did that to my Aunt Lizzie because she thought she was the reincarnation of Lizzie Borden the Ant Smiler.
Did the shock treatment work?
Well, after she killed 4 of the doctors and zapped her, they never bothered her again. So yeah, I guess it worked for her.
Second down and 9. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Third down and 8. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
I don't remember calling 911, but the SWAT team is out in full force at the line of scrimmage. Nice play by the linemen. Third down and 8. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
So much for the bomb's way dirty trick on that play. Didn't fool the defense for a second. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, and that's how you get your buzz on in the NFL. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he got it. Anyone in the mood for Mutant Tartar? Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life. Oh, what a brutal hit. Nicely done. And it's first and 10. Man, what a hit that was. Second down and 10. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. Scrambler. Second down in a very lot. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim. Watch is a bit slow.
Looks like a pass, and wait, the quarterback said they'd blow up the defense today. He was right. Kapow! Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And that's a pick. And now the quarterback is cursing the defense, his receiver.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
And that'll bring up third down. Defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. Third down and three. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and ten. First and ten. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
Second down and five. Tired of the quarterback's tight spirals and magnetic first. And in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
The way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and five.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and five. Nicely done for a first down. First and two.
Hot one, hot two.
Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? Deadline ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks.
Second down and two.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Third and four. Whoa, and he laterals the ball to the player.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
It's all about who can control the line of scrimmage on these short yardage fourth down plays. Usually it's the guy with the biggest butt. And that's just a great run for a touchdown. And this guy has quite the female following. Listen to them.
Yeah, they all want to jump his bones.
I wish the middle linebacker would have jumped his bones. I just lost a sawbuck on that play.
I like this. They're going for two.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down, and ain't gonna happen, partner.
One, hot two, hot three.
And the ball was lateral to his teammate. We're talking he was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Third down and forever.
Hot one, hot two.
Play. They'll need to regroup quickly. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a thought that...
That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and ten.
One, hot two,
three. And they brought him to a dead stop, literally. Oh, man. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
First down and five.
Hot one, hot two,
three. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
Hot one, hot two.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
With the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Wow! It's like a bloodmobile crashing into a slaughterhouse.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
Second down and long.
Hot one.
And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the NFL, you moron.
That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
No, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, with the punishing hit. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, eight.
That's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Third down and 3.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Quarterback likes to play with soft balls, but the defense, they're playing with big balls and just crushed his balls.
That's a lot of balls, man.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalpost if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the QB.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Just fouled. When the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
Look at that little mutant run!
I don't think you can say that, Grim! Oh, boy.
And it's first and 10. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. Desperate. Either way, they're going for two.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate.
One, hot two, hot.
The defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3-yard gain on that pass. Second down and 7.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
I don't know if he even had a target on that throw. And that'll bring up third down and 7.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
He picks up a 2.
Boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
Good thing they don't have drug testing in the NFL, because whenever they can, he's on to the races. And he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run!
If you get one more bullshit penalty, you get one more for free.
You'll also probably lose the game. Just do the attack ref dirty trick.
Looks like and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
He grabs it and picks up 4 on that reception. Second down and 6. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's 1st and 10. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. 2nd down and 10. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
And big deal. Missed a beat for Brace Ram with a ball and didn't fall down.
Just one. Just had some fun on your time.
And these guys think kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for 2.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
2-point plays are high risk, high reward. And it just didn't pay off.
And now they're both screwed and stupid.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
Yeah, what about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And the bomb goes off, hurting no one.
Yeah, but bombs don't kill anyone. Does it still make a sound?
2nd down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot. Hey.
Finds his man for the 1st down. And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one,
and That's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Then why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Third down and 3.
Hot one, hot two, hot
three. You've gotta catch that. The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league. Yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Oh, nice hit. Second and 3. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
Hey, Bricks, they're going for 2 here. And he finds his target for 2. Quarter 3 comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. A 6-yard gain. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's 1st and 10. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. The 10.
It's a touchdown.
like that. Please shoot me.
Sure. You want it between the eyes or the back of the head?
Okay.
And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And it's first and 10. Man, how did he screw that up? No one died.
Bombs don't kill mutants, Grim. Mutants kill mutants.
Second down and 10. Well, that'll trim your nostril hairs once and for all. First and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
A mix of tiger blood, shark blood, and internet comments. Talking about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. And that'll bring up third and one. Shoveled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
They want more points, so they're going for two. And he gets into the end zone for the conversion. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10.
Let me tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel and got blown across the room into the theater antlers.
Second down and 6. Anyone in the mood for Mutant Tartar? And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and 10. should throw it and catch it too. Second down and 10. And that's a run for no gain. Third down and 10. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. And the quarterback threads the needle, and the offense is still alive. Great play for a first down.
Oh, this game is so exciting. I think I just grabbed my pants.
You hell no, fella.
First down. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
First down and 7. Now the QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. They use their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. Man, he's running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick.
Hey, a sawbuck says he misses.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. The Carolina Panzers suffer a big loss today. They battled hard but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation